State Senator Andy Harris will again try to become a Maryland congressman. He officially announced his candidacy today. Good evening, everyone. That's our top story tonight at 6. Harris, the Republican and Hopkins anesthesiologist, made several stops today to announce a rematch this fall with Frank Kratovil.
The Democrat beat Harris in a race to represent the 1st Congressional District. Kratovil won that 2008 race by the slimmest of margins, fewer than 3,000 votes, becoming the first Democrat to win that district in 18 years. 11 News reporter Kate Amar live tonight in Stephensonville with more on today's announcement. Kate.
No, many analysts consider the 1st District to be Maryland's most vulnerable congressional seat. And there are two big factors which could tip the balance in this rematch: fundraising and turnout.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, in case you haven't figured it out yet, I'm here this morning to formally announce that I'm running for Congress in Maryland's 1st Congressional District.
The rematch is now official. On Tuesday, Republican State Senator Andy Harris launched his bid to unseat 1st District Representative Frank Kratovil. The conservative Democrat had a narrow victory in 2008 thanks to strong Democratic turnout, and analysts say the seat will be tough to hold if turnout is down for the midterm elections.
I don't think the people of this district, the state, or the country are that concerned about elections. What they're concerned about is knowing that their congressman is doing everything they can to deal with the economic situation we're facing and doing everything they can to save and create jobs.
The focus for both sides was financial on this first formal day of the campaign. Congressman Kratovil toured PRS guitars in Stephensville to see stimulus dollars at work.
Hi, Frank Kratovil.
Forced to lay off 29 workers so far, the guitar maker is using a $29,000 stimulus grant to train the remaining workforce.
We've been focused on big business, big banks. Now they're taken care of. Well, the problem is that hasn't helped the little guy, and we need to make sure that we're focusing on the small businesses and doing our best to protect the jobs.
Senator Harris said, sharply criticized the stimulus act in his announcement speech and vowed to abstain from earmarks if elected.
It's their dollars they sent to Washington. Washington got a little cut and sent them the scraps back as an earmark. They're smarter than that. Let's just stop sending those tax dollars to Washington in the first place.
Kratovil is also a critic of wasteful spending, and in the name of transparency, posts his earmark requests on his House webpage. It's the first skirmish in what's expected to be a tough and expensive rematch. Both sides spent more than $5 million combined
the last time around. For the country.
Kratovil is currently winning the money race. He's raised more than twice his opponent, according to the latest FEC filings. It's not good news for Andy Harris, who needs a lot of cash if Republican Senator E.J. Pipkin decides to mount a primary challenge like he did last time. Reporting live, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.